Hello, and welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. I can't speak. Do I remember everyone's voices? Okay. Hi, Camilla. Glad to see you didn't run away on us. Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least keep my word. Well, I'm back in the Literature Club again. I was the last to come in, so everyone else is already hanging out. Thanks for keeping your promise, Lehla. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you, making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to it. Oh, come on! Like, he deserves any slack! Sayori told me you didn't even want to join any clubs this year, and last year, too! I don't know if you plan to just come here and hang out or what, but if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it! That's... Suki, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps a manga collection in the club room. Now Suki finds herself stuck between saying Monica and manga.
Manga is literature!
Suki defeated, now Suki pops down on the seat.
Don't worry, guys. Ella always gives best as long as
I'm saying her and we're sticking with that.
Gives her best as long as she's having fun. She helps me with busy work without me even asking. Like cooking, cleaning my room. How dependable.
Sorry, that's because your room is so messy it's distracting.
Oh, Yuri even brought you something today, you know? Wait, Sayori.
Me?
Not really. Don't be shy.
It's really nothing. What is it?
Never mind.
Sayori made it sound like a big deal when it's really not.
What do I do? I'm sorry, Yuri. I wasn't thinking.
Guess it means it's up to me to rescue the situation. Huh. Okay then. Oh, Yuri. Crap. Think she knows me looking at her. Sorry. I was just spacing out.
It's fine. If I was focused, I probably wouldn't have noticed in the first place. But I'm just rereading a bit of this, so...
That's the book you gave me, right?
Mm-hmm. I wanted to reread some of it.
Aw, she's so sweet, trying to read the same area I'm in. Where the heck is my phone?
Not for any particular reason.
Just curious how come you have to... copies of the same book? Wait, what? Oh, just curious. How come you have two copies of the same book?
Well, when I stopped at the bookstore yesterday, that's not what I meant. I mean, I just happened to buy two of them.
I see. Something fairly obviously that... I can't read, so you guys can read for yourselves. I'll definitely start reading it soon.
I'm glad to hear. Once it starts to pick up, you might even have a hard time putting it down. It's a very engaging and relatable story.
Is that so? What's it about, anyway?
Well...
Yuri closes the book and scans her eyes over the back. She's never read it before. I don't think she's read it before. The book is titled Portrait of My Carl. There's an ominous looking eye symbol on the front cover.
Alright. I just wanted to make sure I don't accidentally give anything away.
Okay then.
It's about this high good
reading. Kumbaya. Life gets strange. People!
It's kind of dark, isn't it? You made it sound like it's gonna be a nice story, so that dark turn came from nowhere. Well, I figured it was gonna be dark.
Are you not a fan of that sort of thing, Lehla?
No, it's not that. I mean, I can definitely enjoy those kind of stories, so don't worry. She's such a dandere.
I hope so.
Yeah, I totally forgot your reason to those things. Wait, where are her glasses? You're a dandere, where are your glasses? Where are your glasses?
She's so shy and reclusive on the outside, but her mind seems to be completely different. Just those kind of stories. They challenge you to look at life.
Can't read, guys. Okay, so Yuri is the dandere. Sayori is the dere-dere, or would she be an undere? I think she's a dere-dere, honestly. And, Monica, I still don't know yet. And Natsuki is definitely tsundere. I still don't know about Monica. Yes, you are rambling, but that's okay, so am I. I can't really read right now, out loud. Oh yeah, she's definitely a dandere.
Uh-huh.
That's okay. Like what? What are you gonna say? Oh, she's such a dandere! Oh my gosh! Oh my goodness, she's so cute! Monica turns out to be yandere. That would be so awesome. I open the book and start the prologue. I soon understand what Yuri means about reading in company. It's as if I can feel her presence over my shoulder as I read. Wait, what? That's kinda, sorta, just a little bit awkward. Not particularly a bad thing. You made it seem like it. Feeling is somewhat comforting. Oh, okay. Yuri is in the corner of my eye. I realize she's not actually looking at her own book. Excuse me? I'm gonna need her to look at her own, book. Please. Please, honey. Look at your book. Look at your book, honey. Oh! Oh, okay then. Okay. Oh. Yeah, read my book too. That's fine, actually, honey. I like that. Lehla, read. I am reading. She's reading my book. I don't really mean to. Yay!
Sorry. I mean...
Here, this should work, right? I slide my desk and tilt up against Yuri's and hold my book more between the two of them.
Suppose so.
Yuri timidly closes her own copy. I'm swinging in under the barrel, shoulders are almost tired. Hey! Lehla. Am I gonna put an arm around her? I guess that makes it kind of difficult to turn the page.
Here.
Yuri takes her left arm and holds the left side of the book between her thumb and forefinger. This is a nice angle. Can we talk about that? This is a nice angle. And it's not like I'm being perverted because I'm not staring at boobies. I did the same for my right on the right book. That way I can turn the page and Yuri slides it under the thumb after it flips to the side. But in holding it like this... Wait. Hold on, we're reading the books. Is this Japan or no? Hold on. So she and I turned the page. So that means I'm turning towards. Wait. Do they have books that go in that order? Never mind. Kind of distracting me. It's as if I can feel the warmth of Yuri's face. She's in the corner of my vision. The warmth of Yuri's face. Can we talk about that sentence for a second?
Are you ready?
To
turn the page.
Ah, sorry. I think I got a bit distracted for a second. I glance over at Yuri's face again, and our eyes meet. This is the girl I wanted, by the way. I don't know how I'll be able to keep up with her.
That's okay. You're not used to reading, right? I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer. Probably the least I can do.
I just now realized she's looking at me. Was she always looking at me?
Since you've been so patient with me.
Yeah. Thanks.
I'll continue reading.
Yuri no longer asked me if I'm ready to turn the page. Instead, I just assumed that she finished the page before me, so I turned it by my own violin. Violin! Wow! Volition, Lehla. Volition. Yes, let's say it with me. Volition. We continued the first chapter in silence. Even so, turning each page feels like an intimate exchange. Oh, wow, this is,
My thumb gently letting go of the page, letting it flutter over to her side as she catches it under her own thumb.
Is this how we're gonna raise our children?
Hey, Yuri. This might be a silly thought, but the main character kind of reminds me of you a little bit. You think so? How does she?
Well, I guess she's more blunt in a lot of ways. Okay, so we're going there.
But also second-guesses herself.
Second-guesses all of the things that she says and does.
It's like she's afraid she'll do something wrong.
It's not like I can see into your head or anything. But they kind of... Guys, read for yourselves!
Aw, crap, did I poo-poo? Do I done goof bad?
I done pooped up. Whoops! I done pooped up! Oh, crap. Aw, damn. Wow. Whoops-a-daisers. I mean, potato salads are like macadamia nuts. And, hum-da-da-dum-dum, oh my goodness. I done screwed up. I made things all awkward and everything. I feel bad. I do. I really feel bad, because she's just so confused with life right now, and I'm not helping. Monica to the rescue!
I think it's about time we should...
Oh, I forgot about the pom-poms. I forgot about the pom-poms. I forgot about the pom-poms!
Monica, what are you? Are you Yandere? Please be Yandere. I would be so happy if you are.
Because now we have the Dandere, the Dere-Dere, the Sindere, and the Yandere. Those are the really common types. I don't think she... Nah, she's not a Kudere.
I stand up. I make a mental note where I left off the book and snip it back. Slip. By the way, did you remember to write a poem last night?
Yeah. My relaxation ends. Can't believe I agreed to do something so embarrassing. Couldn't really find much inspiration since I...
Well, now that everyone's ready, why don't you find someone to share it with?
I can't wait!
Sayori and Monica enthusiastically pull out their poems. Sayori is on a wrinkle.
Wow. Oh gosh, what did I write?
Should I show my poem to first? Yuri seems the most experienced, so I should start with her. I can trust her opinion, to be fair.
Jovi's former nose, her eyes lighten.
Exceptional.
Eh? What was that?
Did I say that out loud?
You really didn't do anything wrong, Yuri.
I guess you're right. What am I getting so nervous for? So, what kind of writing experience do you have? Your use of imagery and metaphors indicates you've written a lot of poetry before.
Really? Wow, it's a huge compliment coming from you. This is actually my first time, really. I write a lot in real life, but okay.
Yuri stares at me blankly and looks at my poem again.
Well, I know that. I just meant, Yeah.
Okay. This is the reason I was able to tell. It's just that specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And having been through that myself, I kind of noticed a pick up on them. I think the most notable thing I recognize in new writers is that when they try to make their style very deliberate, in other words, they tend to pick a writing style separate from the topic matter and they form for the two together. The end result is both the style and the questions are weakened.
Of course, that's not something you can be blamed for. There are so many different skills and techniques that go into writing, even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part.
Do you mind if I read your poem now?
Please do. I'd love to share my thought process behind it.
Ghost under the light, the tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow. Fading, it must be this one, the last remaining street light to have withstand the test of time. The last yet to be replaced by sickening blue-green health of future. I bathe, calm, breathing air of the present, but living in the past, the light flickers. I flicker back.
Sorry, I have such terrible handwriting.
What? Yeah, that was kind of hard to read.
I wasn't thinking that at all.
It took you a long time to read.
Well, I just don't read script very often.
I just think your handwriting is pretty.
That's a relief.
Also, I like the poem.
Even though it's short, it was really descriptive.
It wasn't too short? I usually write longer poems.
It wasn't too short, that's what you said? Okay.
Not at all.
I'm really glad you like it. I'll be honest. Since it's our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose. Are you into ghost jury?
Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, Ella.
Really?
I just don't miss the point. Well, I suppose you did only glance over it after all.
Yeah, I know it's not a ghost. I'm not about a ghost, but you know what? I'm gonna play along and pretend I'm stupid.
Remember that poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, experiences, and their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost. Lincoln in her last remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past, and soon to be left with nothing.
That's a lot more solemn putting it that way. I hadn't even thought of that. Yes, I did! That's impressive.
It's nothing, really! This is impressive too, so...
Nah. Anything I could probably learn from the two from you. I am just... She's falling apart. I still don't know what my friends are trying to warn me about. I guess this is only the second episode. I'm gonna do a half hour for this. I'm glad you enjoyed it. For me? Okay. Let's do Sayori and get her out of the way.
Should a poem be sure it's your first time? Of course. It's not that good. Am I the kind of guy, girl, who'd be writing poems in her spare time? Yes, you're so right! Me. Now, to be honest, I was afraid you wouldn't do it seriously, or that you wouldn't write one at all. I'm really happy just that you wrote one. It just reminds me of how you're really part of the club now. Well, of course. Not really into it yet, but doesn't mean I'll break my promise. See? Like I said before, Ella, deep down you're not selfish at all, you know? I guess I'm another Tsundere. Can I do things like this for other people? That's something only really good people do. Thanks, Sayori. Make sure you have lots of fun here, okay? That would be changed my way of thinking you. Alright, I'm gonna hold you to that then. Tsundere! Ima, don't make it a sigh. That's not the actual translation. Don't worry, I'm really bad at this. See about that.
Dear sunshine, the way you glow to my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to help me out of bed, making me rub sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever, but I'm not mad. I want breakfast.
Aww. That's cute. That's really, really... I like the ending the most. I actually really like that part. I'm not mad, I want breakfast.
Sayori, this is just a guess, but did you wait until this morning to write this?
No! Just a little bit.
Can't answer just a little bit to a yes or no question.
I forgot to do it last night. Mom, at least that makes me feel a little better about myself. Don't be mean! I still tried my best!
Yeah. I didn't mean to say that it was a bad poem. Came out nice, or how should I put it? It sounds just like you.
Really?
Yeah.
Especially that last line. I made eggs and toast!
Even though you were late to school.
So I had to skip breakfast. I get all cranky.
You get hangry. No point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me.
This was so much fun. Monica's the best.
Yeah.
Next time I won't forget. And I'm gonna write the best poem ever.
Well, I guess I look forward to it.
Hi, Lehla. Having a good time so far?
Yeah.
Good. Glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, do you have a suggestion for the club, like new activities or things we can do better?
Menagerie sink? No, I'm joking.
I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind.
Of course I'll be afraid to bring that up. Anyway, want to share your poem with me?
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Don't worry, Lehla, we're all a little embarrassed today, you know? But that's sort of better that we'll learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true. Here you go.
Mm-hmm. Great job, Lehla. I was going ooh in my head while reading it. It's really metaphorical. I'm not sure why, but I didn't expect you to go for something so deep. I guess I underestimated you.
It's easy for me to keep everyone's expectations low. I'm sorry. I wish it was like that for me in real life. That way it always counts to put in some effort. Gosh, I wish I had done that in real life. But no, everyone's expectations of me are really, really high. Why? Because I just had to ace my classes and ugh. And don't even get me talking about my scores on the SAT. You really like this kind of writing. I knew you was gonna like it the most. I was writing mostly for like what I think, and I do like the color pink, hot pink. The annoying part is I can't just skip parts of this because it's mostly text and story, not me running around doing stuff. I am not reading out loud, I'm so sorry. Can I read fast?
Else might be a little bit biased towards their own kind of style, but I'll always help you find what suits you most. So don't force yourself to write the way everyone else wants you to write.
That's true. People in real life don't force yourself to be artistic for someone else's ideals, because then you'll feel like you're competing, you'll feel pressure to be perfect. Just do your own thing, do what suits you. Don't do what other people want for you. Do what you want for you. You gotta learn where that line is.
Anyway, do you want to read my poem now? Hell yeah. To the yeah, yeah, yeah. Hell to the yeah, hell to the yeah, yeah.
Alright, let me read this.
Hold on, water couldn't be
to the direction the spackle protrudes, a noisy neighbor, an angry boyfriend I'll never know, I wasn't home. Peer inside for a clue, no, I can't see. I feel blind like a film left out in the sun, but it's too late. My retinas already scorched from the copy of the meaningless image. It's just a little hole, it wasn't too wide, it was too deep. Stretching forever into everything, a hole of infinite choices. I realized now that I wasn't looking in, I was looking out, and he, on the other side, was looking in.
So what do you think?
It's very freeform, if that's what you call it.
Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback. It's okay.
Yeah, that kind of sonnet's gotten pretty popular nowadays.
By the way, people, I do mostly sonnets and rhymes. I like to make my stuff rhyme. I have written stuff that doesn't rhyme, though.
It's a lot of poems have been putting emphasis on the timing between words and lines. When performed out loud, it can be really powerful.
It was inspiration behind this one.
Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem or a story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. You try so hard to make it perfect, then you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on the paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this.
Enter Bendy!
No. So just move your hand and go with the flow. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
That's Natsuki.
Well, it's about what I expected from someone like you.
That's a little blunt.
Well, excuse me. It's not like I said it was bad. Just didn't evoke any emotions. So basically, it's not cute enough.
Oh, so basically, it's not cute enough for your taste? Damn, Lehla.
Do you want to get smacked?
I'll pass.
Anyway, I guess I need to show you mine. Not that you'll like it.
Semicolon, 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 semicolon. Actually, no, forget the semicolon. Comma.
Yeah. I told you you were gonna like it.
I like it.
What? Just be honest.
I am.
Why are you so convinced that I...
Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it?
Well, because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff.
Of course not.
People don't even take my writing seriously.
But isn't the point of poems to express... for people to express themselves?
Yeah,
convey, like, your own message, your own meaning. Your writing style wouldn't make you message any less valid.
Yes, exactly! I like it when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Like in this poem, seeing everyone around you do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it.
Mm-hmm. I thought that was the point. I understand.
But then when I think that's the way it's put my weight on the wordplay. Like, set up for a rhyme at the end, then I made it fall flat on purpose. It helps if we got to feeling in the last line.
So you did. Guess more went into it than I realized.
That's what it means to be a pro. I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here, did you?
Yeah, guess not.
Say something? Oh, it's nothing. I guess you could say it's fancy.
Thanks. Yours is cute.
Cute? Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up. How can that be cute?
I know that. It just meant the language, I guess.
have to try hard to come up with something nice to say? Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all. I'm looking for suggestions. I would have liked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way. Sayori liked it. And Lehla did too. So based on that, I'll gladly give you some suggestions of my own. First of all... Excuse me. I appreciate the offer. I spent a long time establishing my writing style. I don't expect it to change in time soon unless it causes them to cause something particularly inspiring. Which I haven't yet. And Lehla liked my poem too, you know. She even told me that she was impressed by it. I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri. It's not what I... Maybe you're just jealous that Lehla appreciated my advice more than she appreciated yours. Huh? And how do you know she didn't appreciate my advice more? Are you not proud of yourself? No. I was full of myself. I would deliberately go out of my way to make everything I do overly cutesy. Is everyone okay? Well, you know what? I wasn't the one who blew up any of the girls' side figure as soon as Lehla started showing up. Natsuki! Natsuki, that's a little... This doesn't involve you! I don't like fighting, guys. Lehla? She's just trying to make me look bad. That's not true. She started it. She could get over herself and learn to appreciate the simple writing is more effective, and this wouldn't have happened in the first place. What's the point of making these poems all convoluted for no reason?
Oh! Now you fucked up!
Meaning she'd jump out at the reader, not force them to have to figure it out. Help me explain that to her, Lehla. But wait, there's a reason we have so many deeply expressive words in our language. It's the only way to convey comes with feelings that mean the most effectively. Avoiding them is not unnecessarily limiting yourself, it's also a waste. You understand that, right, Lehla? Help me, Sayori! Natsuki. Yuri. Sayori! Everyone is fighting and making Sayori uncomfortable. How can the two of you keep fighting when you know you're making your friend feel like this? Well, that's her problem. This isn't about her. I agree. It's unfair for others to interject their own feelings into our conflict. Yeah, unless Sayori wants to tell Yuri what a stuck-up jerk she's being. She would never. Sure, humanity has made her upset. Immaturity and humanity has made her upset in the first place. Excuse me? Are you listening to yourself? This is exactly why. Exactly why nobody likes. Stop! Listen, you guys are my friends. Happy. Hallelujah. My friends are wonderful people. I love you.
Damn, you see how fast she bounced?
So this is why Sayori is vice president.
She might be an airhead, but sometimes it's really suspicious that she knows exactly what's going on. Oh, she might not be dead-eye. Let me keep going.
I see. Take good care of her, okay? I hate to see her get herself hurt.
That makes two of us. You can count on me.
Okay, everyone. It's just about time for us to leave. How did you all feel about sharing home?
It was a lot of fun.
I'd say it was worth it.
It was alright. Well, mostly.
Well, how about you?
Yeah, I'd say the same. There's new things to talk about with everyone. Awesome! In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow. Maybe you'll learn something from your friends, too. So your poem will turn out even better. Oh, good. Sorry, earlier, about what happened earlier.
What do you mean?
No, between Yuri and Natsuki. Does that kind of thing happen often?
No! It's really the first time I've seen them fighting like that. I promise they're both wonderful people. You don't hate them, do you?
No, I don't hate them. Just wanted your opinion, that's all. I can see why they'd make good friends with you.
You know, Lehla, it's nice that I get to spend time with you as a cloud. I think seeing you get along with everyone is what makes me happiest. And I think everyone really likes you too.
That's...
Every day's going to be so much fun.
I think Sayori does know. Just have to see what the future holds, Sayori.
Okay.
Yeah. Alright, that's enough for this one. Do 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 do.